Okay, hello everyone, and thank you so much for watching. So my name is Kat Nichols, and I'm senior writer here at Happy Fool and Life Coach Directory, and joined here today by Vix, and we're going to be talking about all things online education. So to start with, Vix, I'd love it if you could give us an introduction to yourself and your journey up until now and what you do now.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, first of all, thank you for having me. Very excited to chat today. So my name is Vix. I call myself like an online educator. I used to be a primary school teacher. And when I was primary school teaching, I started my own blog and Instagram channel, which back then was all about dating. And I grew that for a couple of years. And turned it into this kind of like personal brand, in that I was doing documentaries and radio all about dating. But then I met my husband and I couldn't talk about dating anymore. So I had to pivot my brand a bit and went down the kind of like lifestyle content creation route. From there, I just started getting really interested in building your brand online, marketing, social media, blogging, content creation, content marketing, all of that kind of stuff just started to fascinate me. So I started taking lots of courses, trainings, and sort of upskilling myself. And then I've sort of found my passion, because I left teaching but still wanted to be a teacher in some ways. And I thought, okay, this is brilliant. I can teach everything that I've learned about building your brand online to other people who are trying to build their brands online. So that started originally with like e-courses and e-books and templates and all of that kind of digital product stuff to begin with. But then it turned into a membership in May 2019. And that is my Grow and Glow membership, Grow and Glow community, which is for people who are the face of their brands, learning how to build their brand online. So yeah, content, social media, branding, all of that fun stuff. And that's what I do now. So I use my Instagram to educate people on building your brand online. And then we've got the lovely Grow and Glow community. So that's me.
I love that. And I think that's why we really wanted to chat to you, because I think you're in this really unique position of being on both sides of it. So you are a teacher, you know, you are a teacher, you have been a physical teacher in schools, and you embrace the learning yourself. You're very into personal development stuff. So I want to talk firstly about investing in yourself, whether that's with money or with energy, with time, because I think for a lot of us, this can be quite difficult. And I was just wondering if you could share maybe some either personal experiences of yours, or maybe experiences of students, of why it can be so beneficial to invest in yourself in this way.
Yeah, definitely. So I always consider myself a lifelong learner. And I think that's a value that we hold at Grow and Glow as well. We want our members to be lifelong learners, because I don't ever think you get to a place where you know it all. I think there's always more that you can learn, always more that you can, you know, broaden your mind and horizons on all different aspects of either within your business or within yourself and your personal development. So I hold that value really dear, because every kind of thing that I've learned along the way has come through investing in learning, whether that's been through coaching or whether that's been through courses and programs. Every single time I've taken a course or done, you know, a period of life coaching or coaching with somebody, it's taken me to that next level. It's given me that next boost of confidence. It's given me that next skill that I can then go on and apply. So I am a huge fan of learning myself. And similarly with Grow and Glow members, they come to us as the community because they know where they want to get to, but they're just not quite sure how to get there. And yep, you could spend, which is what I did back in the day, hours Googling, searching Pinterest, reading every blog post, every article, every book possible. Or you can invest in a course or a program over a shorter period of time. And not only does that help you with your knowledge, but it also helps you as a person, because I think sometimes when we actually invest in ourselves, we take it more seriously, we commit more, and we say, okay, well, you know, I've paid this, so I'm gonna show up for it, and I'm going to kind of get my money's worth. So yeah, investing in yourself has that element of that mindset element there, where when you know that you've handed over your details, you know you need to show up, and that can be that bit of motivation sometimes that we need.
Absolutely. It's like that extra bit of accountability, as you said. It's like, I've done this, I'm gonna now make sure I'm getting something out of it. Definitely. Yeah. So we've mentioned learning and about how you love to be a lifelong learner, and I love that. And I thought with your experience, you might have something to say about different learning styles and maybe how people can identify how they learn best.
Yeah, definitely. I always go back to being a primary school teacher, where we were taught about visual auditory and kinesthetic learning. So some people prefer to learn because they see something being done and then they can replicate it. Some people prefer to learn because they can hear and they can listen to the words and that's how it helps them sink in. And then some people prefer to learn by doing. And I think that that's the key thing that in the doing sometimes is that you're out there, you make the mistake, and then you learn from the mistake that you've done. So I think that's a good way for you to just kind of reflect on, have you perhaps, you know, for the people out there, have you perhaps taken a course that's all visual and at the end of it, you're just like, whoa, I didn't learn anything there? Because it may be that you actually needed to do the doing for it to sink in properly. Some people can just learn by watching something and then replicating it. But I find that generally the best way to learn is to give something a go and to make a mistake and go, oh, okay, that didn't work. I'm going to try it a different way. So yeah, it's about that self-reflection. You know, some people can listen to a podcast series and come away from it and just crack straight on and know exactly what they're doing. But yeah, you kind of need to think for yourself, in any times that you've been learning, whether that's been at school, whether that's been a course or a program that you've taken, which element of that sunk in the most for you, and go from there. But I think whatever learning style you have, I don't think it's truly embedded until you give it a go. Because I think, and you know, I fully call myself out here because I can do this sometimes, is that I can learn. I can just like read everything, take all these courses, absorb. And just keep doing that and keep doing that. But until I actually take action on whatever it is that I'm learning. So last year I invested in like a Facebook ads course, and a lot of it was visual diagrams and then set this up and then set that up. But it wasn't until I then actually went into Facebook and started making my own Facebook ads account, putting my own ads out there and putting them live, could I really understand how it worked. So if you're in that position where you are investing in learning or thinking about investing in learning, the first thing you should think to yourself is, how are you going to put it into action? How are you actually going to give it a go? And not to be that sort of passive absorber.
I can really relate to that. I've gone through a series of myself at the moment of attending lots of workshops and taking lots of kind of classes and things like that, and I've learned a lot, and I'm definitely at that point now where I need to sit down and kind of almost collate all of my thoughts and actually do something with them. So I definitely agree with you there, it's a really good point. And with this in mind, the whole idea of figuring out your learning styles, once maybe you've got that figured out, have you got any other tips to help people identify what kind of course or event or program might be right for them?
Yes, definitely, because I think sometimes the kind of general things that happen are like a passive course that you sort of download and you can watch it in your own time. That is often better for people who maybe get a bit overwhelmed if it's a live program, who perhaps need to take things at a slower pace. Perhaps they need to go back and re-watch something, re-listen to something, re-read something for it to sink in. So that's something to think about. Do you prefer that kind of aspect where it is at your own pace, where you can just, you know, absorb it and let it sink in because you need it in that way to give yourself that space? Other types of programs are those like live programs where you're with an instructor, it's over, you know, an amount of days, weeks or months period, and you have a regular interval of teaching and learning. They can be better for people who sometimes need that accountability, who need to know, like, if I'm showing up on Monday night to take this part of the program, it means I've actually got to get my previous works worth of work done so that I'm caught up. Some people like that kind of almost that pressure of like, right, keep up. So that's something to figure out for yourself as well, because actually for some people that can be quite overwhelming because life can get in the way, or you can have lots of other things that you've got on your to-do list and you forget, you know, the course in between the month or the week or the day that you had the previous session. And then it can feel a bit pressurizing to be like, right, got to catch up. But some people thrive on that. So I think that's something to reflect on in yourself as well, what type of learner you are. And then also there's the difference between group programs and one-to-one learning. Some people prefer one-to-one because they get the sole attention of the instructor and they can get much more bespoke feedback. And sometimes that's why people prefer one-to-one to group programs. However, I'm much more of a fan of group programs because I feel like in those programs, not only do you get the feedback from the instructor, but from everybody else in the group as well. And when you can see how everyone else in the group is applying what it is that they're learning, sometimes that sparks something in you that you didn't think about before. So yeah, it's again going back on that self-reflection on how you learn best and at what pace you like. Do you need the accountability or do you prefer to take your time with it?
Yeah, I love that. And I'm glad you brought up the group versus one-to-one, because I think that's a really interesting kind of debate. And I've definitely done both, and I think I'm with you. I do quite like the group programs because you can also connect with other people. And I've made friends with people who I was on a course with, and now we see each other regularly, and we've become like friends for years. So I think there's so many layers of benefits to that potentially that can come up. Brilliant. So I'd love to hear a little bit more about, so if you are taking a course or you're taking a program, how can you maybe stay engaged with the learning? Perhaps maybe it's a self-led one you're doing yourself. Have you got any tips for that?
Yeah, I think sometimes that comes into the course structure as well. I think when you're thinking about joining a course, if you are somebody who needs that accountability or you need to be able to have space to take action, then you need to make sure that the course that you're taking is able to facilitate that. Because if your learning style is that you're somebody who needs to do the doing, but the course is very, very passive, you might not be the person who can self-motivate to do the doing. So I would always look into the course structure and how it's facilitated to see if that matches how you learn best as well. What lots of our Grow and Glow members often do at the beginning of joining is they get themselves like their own notebook or their own journal. And even in some of the trainings that are the more passive trainings, they just put it all in that one space, because I think they feel like it's compartmentalizing in their brain. You know, this is what I'm learning about this subject, this is the other stuff that I'm doing is somewhere else. So again, how you learn best. Perhaps you know, I remember it being at uni, if I sat and just listened to a lecture, at the end of it I'd forgotten everything that was said. But if I sat and took notes and in those notes wrote myself reflective questions and wrote myself, you know, questions to come back on, that helped it sink in a little bit more. But yeah, I think sometimes with courses and programs that it's on the facilitator and instructor to say, you know, how they're going to hold space and how the course is going to be delivered, and needs to really make that clear, because then the learner knows what they're getting into. And if they know they're a type of person who needs sinking in time and action time and reflection time, then they need, you know, then they know that the course facilitates that.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's an interesting point, actually, because we've talked about maybe choosing which course or program is right for you, but not necessarily talking about the instructor. And I think that's really important. I know if I'm going to be taking a course from someone or something, I tend to have followed them on social media for quite a while, and I know a bit more about them. Do you have any thoughts on that, or kind of ideas of how people can get to know what facilitator might be right for them or how they can get into that?
Yeah, I think good facilitators, you know, you do follow them online, mm-hmm. and you get a sense of their teaching style because they do lives, or they do like teaching on stories, or perhaps like the questions that they ask on Instagram or via their blogs or whatever, or their newsletters, whatever platform you follow them on. The questions they ask are those really deep and open and juicy questions, and you find yourself learning from their free content, whether that's a blog post, podcast, Instagram or whatever, and you learn and you realize, oh yeah, that's really sunk in, or how they've worded that has really resonated with me, or I really like how they've put that, that's actually helped me learn. I think that exactly like you said, you do end up watching them for a while and you think, is this like a style? Is this person's style like the type of style that I like? So I think that definitely does help to get almost like a taster of what it will be like. And again, I think good instructors and good facilitators do give away a lot of free value and a lot of free education so that people can get used to what they do.
Yeah, exactly. And if you are getting value from what they're giving away for free, it's kind of think about, wow, what would happen if I invested in something they're offering? Like, what more can I get from them? That's a really good point. And we've touched on this a little bit already about this idea of taking action, but I know this is something you're quite passionate about, so I'd love to hear more thoughts on this, about how we can maybe get out of that researching and learning mode and putting what we've learned into action.
Yeah, and I think sometimes that part is very much in play in our own confidence and our own belief in ourselves, because sometimes learning can be overwhelming, because it can give us everything, you know, which is great, but it can also highlight everything we didn't know. And then when we look at that and we think, oh my gosh, I've got all of this to learn, that then makes us feel like we don't know anything. So then it becomes a confidence issue being able to put it into practice, because it's been highlighted what we kind of don't know. So I think like those really small bursts of action, just consistently putting stuff into place, is going to serve you better, because if you, you know, you wait till the end of a course or you wait until your to-do list is like 400 things long, you're going to feel like, oh my gosh, this is insurmountable. All of this stuff I've never done before. I've never learned before. How am I going to implement all of this? But if you can take those like smaller chunks of action, that helps. And again, I think that comes down to your learning style as well. If you are the type of person who, you know, they can have a 400 to-do list and think, right, I'm going to have 2 days and I'm absolutely just going to crank this out. I'm very self-motivated. Off I go. Then great. That's going to work for you. But if you are the type of person who, you know, does need that accountability, self or from others, or that kind of, you know, the cheerleading of like, come on, you can do this, and celebrating those smaller steps of action, then you need to kind of choose your instructor and course and program based on that. And I often think, you know, within Grow and Glow, the trainings that we do are very sort of like straight to the point, very short. You know, there's one objective, one thing you're going to learn, one thing to kind of take away. And we also have like task lists, which are things you can do in 2 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 30 minutes, 60 minutes. It's just being able to do those little bits that add up. And then at the end, you'll see that you've achieved this whole objective, but you've just done it in smaller chunks.
I love that. And that's such a good point, because I think it can be quite overwhelming, especially if maybe you've signed up to a 6 month long project or something, or a course or something like that. And just, yeah, taking those small, tiny steps and to get that confidence growing is really key. Perfect. Well, thank you so much, Vix. And before we wrap up, I'd love it if you could share where everyone can find out more about you.
Oh, brilliant. Well, thank you for having me. That was a great chat. I love talking about learning and things, so thank you very much. On Instagram, you can find me at Grow with Vix. And if you want to find more about our Grow and Glow community, we are at www.growglow.co. And on Instagram, we're at growglow.co. So that's where you can find us.
Perfect. Thanks so much, Vix. And if anybody watching has felt inspired by this and maybe wants to look at some more courses and things like that, you can head over to lifecoach-directory.org.uk and find out more from professional coaches over there. Thanks so much.